Okay, let's start the class. I check your answers. There is one thing which I want to tell you, but So about one question. So what? Uniform magnetic field. So basically, if you are told to draw uniform magnetic field,
so we can't see green, sir. Just plain orange.
I'll see you. Hold on. Okay, now is it visible?
Yeah, sir. This is sir.
Got it? Hold on.
Got it, sir.
Yeah, just 1 minute now. Okay, so I was just telling you about that question about uniform magnetic field. Okay, that is, if you are told to draw a uniform magnetic field, hold on, let me reduce the size. That is, if you are given two magnets like this. Okay. The two magnets are given. One is north, one is south. Okay. Just simply draw straight lines from north to south. Equally spaced straight lines. This is the direction, right? From north to south. Okay. So this is enough. Okay. No need to draw all these. Lines. No need to draw all these things. Okay, so this
draw the lines.
Okay, so this alone is enough. These straight lines are
just the union. The union or something. That one enough, sir.
Yeah. If you draw the straight lines over here, okay, this is enough. Okay. Don't have to draw any other. Lines like this. Okay, don't draw all the. Okay, draw straight lines. Okay, straight lines.
So the curve starts from north to curve at the top of the lines.
No, don't draw. For uniform magnetic field, only draw straight lines. Okay. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so today let's move on to the next topic. You know, for some reason the computer is slow here. Hold on. Someone is joining. Who's that? Mohammed Zaid. Okay, next topic. What's up, why late, man?
Nothing, sir.
What?
Same picture, sir. Same picture.
What did he say?
Nothing, sir.
Okay. Did we start this? No.
We didn't start.
Okay, all right. Okay, so this is your next chapter, chapter 21. This is about electromagnetic induction, electric motors and electromagnetic induction. Okay, so the basic principle for any motor, you know, it is based on motor effect. It works based on the motor effect. Remember this. Okay. So if you take a wire like this, and if you pass current through the wire, you will have a magnetic field, like, right? Correct. And if you have a bar magnet or a unimagnetic field.
Sir, in the diagram you said wrong one side. You said the way north is correct and south is wrong. Sir, for me.
From north to south.
Yeah, sir. No, sir. From north to south, I did. You said you just like crossed marks from the south side. You said north side it was correct. You just put a tick, sir.
Okay, I'll just find out. Huh? I'll find out. Right. So if you have a magnet, two magnets, north south pole, then you also will have a uniform magnetic field like this. Okay, I'm just drawing it roughly. Okay. So now, if you place this wire, which has an electromagnetic field, if you place this wire inside this, you know, magnetic field that is between these magnets, this wire, you know, it will experience force. It will experience a force. Okay. So basically, it will experience an upward force. Basically, an upward force. That is, this force is due to the overlapping of these two magnetic fields. Okay, understand? Did you get it?
Sir, can you repeat, sir? I had network problems, sir. Was not able to hear your voice properly.
Yeah. So this is a wire carrying a current. So obviously there will be a magnetic field around it in concentric circles, right? And this is two magnets having magnetic field in between them, uniform magnetic field. Now if you place this wire inside this magnetic field, this wire will move upwards. It will experience a force. Why? How? Because of the overlapping of the fields of the magnetic, that is of both the wire and the magnets. Understand?
The wire will move upwards, sir.
Yes, the wire will move upwards, just like a magnet. It will behave. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Clear? Okay. Let's go to the book. Okay. So this is what they are showing here. This is the uniform magnetic field between two bar magnets, and this is the cylindrical field. You know, cylindrical field, concentric circles formed due to the current in the wire. Okay. So if you place this wire carrying current inside this field, it will experience a upward force. This is due to the resultant field due to the overlapping of the two magnetic fields. Okay. Understand? Okay. So just underline this, these two lines. The overlapping of two magnetic fields as produces a motion. This is called as the motor effect. Okay.
Sir, page number, sir.
Page number, hold on.
108, sir. There, 108 in the corner.
207.
207 is 207, sir.
Yeah.
Which one should be underlined, sir?
The last two lines. These two, okay? Got it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, so this is the this is due to the overlapping of the two magnet wheels, which produces what? Motion. Okay, and the direction of the motion is also, it also depends upon the direction of the current inside the wire. Okay, if the current is in this direction, that is, if it is flowing from positive to negative this way, that is, if it is flowing perpendicular to the magnetic field in this direction, right, it will move upwards. Suppose we change the direction. If the direction is opposite, in the opposite side, then the force will act on the other side, that is, it will move downwards. Okay, clear? By switching the direction of the current, you can also change the direction of this force. Okay, clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is what you know, next page 208 in next part, next page in number 208 says that if we change the direction of the current or the magnetic field, both can be changed, a different overlapping pattern is created and we will see the wire moving in the opposite direction. Underline this also. Okay, done. Done, boys.
Yeah, sir.
Now, if you want to have a very strong force, you like to move the wire with a very strong force, then you need to have a strong, either a strong magnet or you have to have a large current. Okay? So either you have to have a strong magnet or you have to have a large current. Okay, then you will see that the wire is moving with much stronger force. Okay, now in the last chapter we learned Fleming's right hand rule, right? Now we are going to learn the Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, now I want you to keep your right hand, make, you know, a gun like, you know, gesture with your right hand. Make a gun like gesture with your right hand. Got it?
Yes, sir.
Are you doing it?
A gun like
gesture.
Yes,
keep your right hand just like how you know, hold a gun. Then you slightly, point your middle finger towards your left. Point your middle finger, only the middle finger, okay? Point your middle finger towards your left. Okay. Now, your thumb, it shows the direction of the force. The thumb shows the direction of your, sorry, of the force. Okay.
What force?
Yeah, force of, you know, force, the force which happens due to the overlapping of the magnetic field.
Yes.
Okay.
Ah.
So,
okay,
the thumb shows you the direction to which the wire will move upwards. Okay. Then your finger of this shahada, the shahada finger shows you, the first finger shows you the direction of the magnetic field from north to south, and the middle finger shows you the direction of the current. So this is your magnetic field, direction of your magnetic field, that is your first finger, second finger, that is your middle finger, shows you the direction of the current in the, and the thumb shows you the direction of, clear? So this is known as Fleming's right, left and boys. Any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay, similar to Fleming's right hand rule. Okay, but few changes are there, need to remember. Okay. Okay. Any doubts?
Oh, sir, but this is the left hand thing, no, sir. You said right hand, no, sir. It's Fleming's left hand rule, no, sir. Sir?
Yeah, this is Fleming's left hand rule.
The right hand rule is the magnetic thing, sir. The magnetic field one. Yeah. Pointing the thumb up and that thing, sir.
Yeah, the right hand rule, Fleming's right hand rule tells us about, you know, the magnetic field around a current carrying wire.
On the magnet. Hmm.
Oh. Okay, so this is this Fleming's left hand rule tells us about the motor effect. Okay.
Hmm.
Okay, yeah. So with Fleming's left hand rule, we can predict the direction of the force or movement of the wire. Okay, so just note down this key point over here, very important, might come in exam. They might ask you what is the use of Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, so just make note of that.
What thing, sir?
We can predict the direction of the force or movement of the wire using Fleming's left hand rule. Underline this whole thing.
Yeah.
Done. Okay. Next, it's moving coil loudspeaker. Is it raining there?
It's just cloudy here, Ustad. I think it's going to rain soon.
Which area?
But it hasn't rained
too much cloudy here, Ustad.
Vadapalli.
Vadapalli.
Yes.
It's raining like anything, man. Yeah, in Roypeta.
Oh, it looks like it's raining there. From here, like outside, like the far area, it looks like it's raining heavily.
Yeah, it's raining here. It's raining here. It's raining heavily over here.
Here it's just cloudy. It's not.
Yeah, Vadapalli might be next.
Next, yes, yeah. That's very cloudy.
Okay, next topic is moving coil loudspeaker. This is nothing but your usual speaker. Okay, any speaker works based on this concept. Okay, again, motor effect. Okay, you take any speaker which is there in your cell phone or your sound box, whatever it is, your television, anything. So it is based on electromagnetism and motor effect. Okay, so first let's discuss about the main components of a loudspeaker. So this is a loudspeaker. Loudspeaker has a permanent magnet inside. This is a permanent magnet. Okay, this one. Let me zoom it out. Let me zoom in. Now, is it big enough? It's quite big, right? Okay. So this is your permanent magnet. See, it is north, south, north. Okay. And inside these, you know, this magnet, you have a wire. Okay, which carries current from the source. Okay, Then number three is your non-magnetic case. This is not magnetic. And number four, this is your paper cone, vibrating paper cone which is connected to the wire. Okay, so remember this paper cone, this is directly connected to the wire. Okay, so when the electrical source, when the electrical signal from the source comes in, right, it has what? It has also a magnetic field. So this magnetic field of this electrical wire will interact with the magnetic field of this magnet, permanent magnet. So though both will overlap, so there will be a constant motion, right? Any doubts? Oh, you're hearing me?
Ah, yes, sir. Can I had you, sir. Problems with my mic, sir. Yes, sir.
Can hear you, sir.
Okay, so when this current will move inside the wire, magnetic field of this current wire will interact with the magnetic field of this magnet. So there will be overlapping. Okay? So, like we already discussed, if we change the direction of the magnetic field, then the movement, that is the force, can also be changed, either upwards or downwards, right? So, the current which comes from the source, right, the signals, the current which comes up, comes inside, it keeps on changing in size and direction. It keeps on changing in size and direction. Very important keyword, okay, remember. The current which represents the sound are always changing in size and direction. Okay, so when the when there is a change in the size and the direction, okay, so this wire will vibrate, right? The wire will move up and down or front or back, however it is arranged. So there will be a movement inside this wire. This wire will move. And when the wire is moving, you know, this wire is connected to the paper cone. So what will happen? The paper cone will also vibrate. Okay, so this, when this paper cone vibrates, it produces sound. Okay, just like our vocal cord there in our throat. Okay, understand? Anyone? Just read this ma. First read this, then we'll.
Yeah, sir, which one, sir?
The moving coil loudspeaker uses the motor effect to transfer electrical energy to sound energy. Electric currents from a source such as radio pass through the coils of the of a speaker. These currents, which represent sounds, are always changing in size and direction, like vibrating sound waves. The field of the coil and the permanent magnet are therefore creating magnetic field patterns, which are also always changing in strength and direction. These fields in turn apply rapidly changing forces to the wires of the coil, which cause the speaker cone to vibrate. These vibrations create the sound waves we hear.
Very good. Any doubts? You have any doubts?
No, sir.
Okay, very good. So let me highlight the keywords. Keywords you cannot change, okay? You can't write your own keywords. Whatever there in the textbook, you have to simply, you have to use the same keywords. Otherwise, you will lose marks. Understand? I'll just highlight those keywords. Yeah. Always changing in size and direction. This is one keyword. Note it down, okay? Just, you can also just make a note that these are the keywords. next keyword is this, the fields of the coil and the permanent magnet. The next keyword is this.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, can you repeat the working of the speaker, sir?
Yeah, first note down the keywords. Third keyword is this. Changing in direction and strength. Sorry. Yes, changing in strength and direction. Then lastly, this is the keyword, apply rapidly changing forces to the wires of the coil. Okay, clear? Hold on. Okay, any doubts?
I repeat the working of speaker, sir.
Yeah, yeah. See, listen here. See, the signal comes from either radio or anything. For example, from your CD player or whatever it is, the signal comes from here, enters the wire. Okay. And it creates a magnetic field, and this magnetic field of this wire interacts with the magnetic field with the magnetic field of this permanent magnet. Okay, it keeps on interacting. Okay, see, the signal which comes inside the wire, it is not static, it keeps on changing in size and direction. Okay, because even the sound is like that, right? Sound is also like that. So it keeps on changing its size and direction. Okay, and it interacts with the field of the permanent magnet. So both the fields, the field of the coil, the field of the permanent magnet, they create a magnetic field pattern, which is also how it is, it is also changing in strength and direction. So that causes the wire to vibrate. Okay, the wire which is there inside, it vibrates like this. Since this paper cone is connected to this wire, the paper cone, even the paper cone vibrates. So this vibration of the paper cone produces what? Produces the sound waves. Okay, so that is how we get what? Different types of sounds. Okay, either it's voice or music, whatever it is, this is how we get the sound. Okay, even our vocal cord is there inside the throat, the vocal cord, even it works similarly. Okay, inside the, that is the voice chamber. Okay, inside voice chamber there is this vocal cord, throats. Okay, so even this works similar fashion, in similar fashion, it vibrates actually. Clear, Adnan?
Yes, sir.
Okay, anyone has any doubts?
No, sir, the speaker all depends on magnetic field.
Kind of complicated.
Sorry, the speaker?
The speaker depends on magnetic fields as well.
Yeah, the magnetic field of both the wire and the magnet. Okay.
Yes, sir.
So while you're writing an answer for this, suppose they ask you the answer, that is, if they ask you to write about a loudspeaker, you have to write properly with all the, you know, keywords which I have told you to underline. Okay, you don't write everything on your own. If you write on your own, you will lose marks. Okay, so use these keywords only. Okay, clear? Okay, so one last thing is, what sound loudspeaker does is it transfers the electrical energy into sound energy. Okay, you just highlight this. Transfers the electrical energy to sound energy. Okay. Clear? Clear, boys?
Yes, sir.
Who is absent today? Who is absent?
I don't know, sir. I think Arshad, sir. I think only Arshad, sir.
Arshad
paid the fees.
Yeah, Arshad has paid.
Yeah, I'm talking about Arman.
Only Arshad was not there, sir. I think Arshad joined, sir. I think he joined and left again, sir. I think he joined and left again.
Okay.
I think all of them are present, sir.
Okay, just hold on.
Yes, Arshad, Abdul Ofurham, I mean, Arman, Abdul Ofurham, they don't come in. And excluding them, Arshad, that's it. Only Arshad.
Abdul Ghafur is also not very regular, right?
He doesn't come to any class right now, sir.
Yeah, sir.
They didn't pay fees, sir.
Yeah, Arman.
Okay. And in last class, it was Max, right? What you had, Max? What was your last class? So you had all present?
Maths.
Maths, yes, Arshad. Maths, Arshad came. So all present. Well, excluding the three, but.
Okay. Okay, right. So, okay, hold on. Okay, for tomorrow you just study page number 207 and 208. Okay, for tomorrow we'll have a small quiz, online quiz. Okay boys.
Okay,
and do revision of the previous chapter also, chapter 20, because it is interconnected. Okay,
sir.
Study electromagnetic induction.
Inshallah, sir.
Okay boys, so I'll leave you below, inshallah. Okay, you can leave the class. Assalamu alaikum.
Yes, sir. Wa alaikum assalam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.